Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to yet another brand new Let's Play. My 3DS is freaking out because I'm talking. This time we are actually going to be starting up a 3DS game as opposed to a DS game. And, well, I'm just going to go ahead and put the cartridge in. I mean, you already know what it's going to be because it says it in the title, but whatever.
Super Mario 3D Land!
One of my favorite 3DS games, Super Mario 3D Land. And I just want to test something out, actually. The 3D is off right now. Now, I know that the capture software thingy does not do 3D, like, when I just turn it on or whatever. But I'm just going to turn the 3D on and take a quick look at what happens. Okay, so it just moves it a little bit. That's pretty interesting. Alright, let's jump into this. I decided I wanted to bring you guys a DS game and a 3DS game at the same time. Or, you know, somewhat the same time. Depending on when I actually end up releasing. I honestly don't even know what my release schedule for these games is going to be yet. Now, I actually already have a save file here, which I do not need. Just get rid of that. I'm going to start a brand new save file. File A. Actually, hold on. There we go. I want to just show you guys this little opening video here. Because I remember when I first got this game, I watched this video and I was like, oh yeah, this... And with this music, I was like, yeah, this feels awesome. This is gonna be a good game. And, it is. It is one of my favorite 3DS games out there. One of the originals. I think it came out in 2011. Which, at the time you guys are seeing this, that's 4 years. I mean, the game hasn't been out 4 years, because I think it was November 2011. Or December 2011. One of them. But still, I guess at the time, it's roughly about 3 years then. So... But it's been out a while, but it's still an amazing 3DS game, and it's one of my favorites, as I've said. So if you leave the video going for a while, it takes you to this little, like, I guess, test area kind of thing? And I just, like, bounced off of that toad. And if I were to turn the 3D on, I don't know how it's gonna look on the screen. Yeah, it sort of moves it a little bit, but on my screen, I can actually see that this is a separate platform. I'm gonna turn the 3D off. Because actually having the 3D on, well, I guess I'll show you when I go into the actual game, but having the 3D on sort of, what am I trying to say? Oop, I bumped the mic. I don't know how I'm trying to say this. It sort of makes stuff look like it's off-center. Anyway, so we gotta choose a me. I am just gonna choose my own me, but I could go with, like, Diglett. I could go with Iron Man, Bill Trinan, got Levi, we got Kawashima, a Smash Ball, so many Attack on Titan people, Ash Ketchum. I think I have Xander Mobus in here, that's RDV. Michael Rosen, that's the arrow guy as well. I could have sworn that I have Xander Mobus in here. Maybe. Somewhere. There he is. That's the announcer from Smash Brothers 4. Let's just go with my me. And I'm gonna try and make these episodes into one world per video. Anyway, cutscene. Oh no! Surprise, surprise! Princess Peach has been kidnapped again! Who would've thunk it? So let's just go on here and let's get started with World 1-1. Listen to this music. I love this music! Alright, I want to test something out before we get going. You'll see those two 3D modes that appeared. I've got the 3D... Just turn the 3D on. As you'll see, it sort of moves it. It looks like it's kind of off-center or whatever. You can have two 3D modes. One that makes it pop out, and one that makes it look like it's more inwards. Now, for you guys, it just looks like it's moving Mario a little bit, but for me, it does... It changes it. I'm going to be playing with the 3D off, though, just because, I don't know. I don't want it to look a little odd on the screen, so I'm just going to leave it off. Which is probably how I'm going to go for pretty much all of the 3DS videos that I do. Come here, you. Give me the Tanuki Leaf, which is the item that was primarily, like, advertised, I guess. When this game was being advertised. They brought it back from, like, Mario 3. I hope I'm not getting that wrong. But you can jump and you can float like this by holding the jump button. You can spin around using the X button or the Y button. Usually X or Y are your run buttons and also your attack buttons. And A and B are your jump buttons. And you can ground pound with R. You can crouch with L or R, actually. So you can also ground pound with L. I always just use R. And I want to show off a couple of techniques here. You can do a long jump. Well, actually, you can crouch and move around by holding R and then moving. And then once you've charged that for a bit, you do another jump. And it's like a backflip. If you crouch while running and then jump, you'll do a long jump. But if you crouch and then hit the run button again, so like you can just crouch, hit the run button, and then jump while you're moving like that, you'll do like a long jump, but you'll also be like going considerably faster, I feel. So, ooh, hello, secret. What do we got in here? A one-up. That is it. But yeah, so the Tanuki suit is like the primary item or power-up in this game. It's even on the frigging logo, so... Well, yeah. As you'll have seen what I collected a little earlier, that thing on the bottom screen? That is what is known as a star medal. I'm gonna keep getting them mixed up. I'm gonna call them comet medals. I'm gonna call them star medals. But they are called... Sorry, no, I'm gonna call them star coins, but they are called star medals. And there's three of them in every level. So I'm going to be going for all of those, of course. Now, the interesting thing about this room is if you have the 3D on, you can actually kind of see that this block is not where it looks like it is. But if you stand on this, then it does, in fact, move the camera so you can see. They actually expect you to have the 3D on there because it even says 3D at the bottom. But yeah, so there's going to be three star medals in every level. I got to get used to calling them star medals because I seriously keep wanting to call them star coins. Now, you'll see we've got another Tanuki suit here. Once we collect it, it appears on the bottom screen. And if I were to lose this one, I can tap that one on the bottom screen using my finger, and it will give us another Tanuki suit. So, item storage in this game is very useful, especially for later levels. Like, tougher levels, you definitely want to go in with, like, more items, or at least try to keep one in your stocked up on the bottom screen or whatever. And I missed that coin, and that is going to annoy me. Alright, so World 1, it's like the simple levels as you could sell. And actually, let's just show this off. I'm actually moving the 3DS around now. Which is kind of impractical when you've got like a cable coming out of it. But you can also just use the circle pad. And oops, I pressed the wrong button. It wants me to zoom in on Toad. Hello. And he is gonna try and get top of the flagpole by the looks of things. Go for it, Toad. You suck, Toad. I'm sorry. So Toad can't do that, but basically what Toad's trying to show off there is that as well as the three star medals in every level, if you want to go for 100%, you also have to get top of the flagpole. It's known as like a golden flagpole. So there's our third star medal. You can just jump off of that rope to sort of... If you jump when you land on it, then you go a lot higher. And I'm going to just ground pound this Goomba real quick. This huge Goomba. Excuse me, sir. Okay, there we go. Okay. Now, for top of the flagpole, it's very easy with the Tanuki suit. As you'll see, you can just float and get top of the flagpole. Simple as that. There really is nothing more to it than that. But if you don't have a Tanuki suit, you can do, like, the rolling long jump thing that I mentioned. And that can be fairly useful. And with that, we unlock World 1, 2. Alright. And as you'll see there, it shows all of the star medals that we collected up at the top middle, and at the bottom right, there's a little golden flagpole. And that shows that we got golden flagpole in that level. So, that's what you want to go for 100%. Alright, let's go onto World 1, 2. Actually, these don't have names. I'm thinking of Mario 3D World, where they all have, like, individual level names, but that's not how it is in this game. Oh god, that was close. I believe we get a new power-up here. Yes, we do! The Fire Flower! I say new power-up. It's a power-up that's been around since Super Mario Brothers, but it's a new power-up that we haven't gotten in this game so far. And I actually want to show off what this guy does here. Let's just get him to attack. Go for it, dude. He, like, sprays the screen with ink, and if you got the 3D on, it's kind of... Like, you can really see the depth behind the ink. It's pretty cool. It, like, looks like the ink is popping out. But, of course, I'm not playing with the 3D on. But they're pretty easy to take out, just like a regular, like... piranha plant. Speaking of, isn't that the first piranha plant we've encountered? Because if so, I don't get why they didn't make it just a regular piranha plant that we encounter at the beginning. But whatever, it's easy enough to defeat. Alright, now, coming up, actually, I think it's just after this section, there's actually a place you can get infinite 1-ups. You can get infinite 1-ups in World 1-2. Although, to be fair, you can also get infinite 1-ups in World 1-2 in Super Mario 3D World, and in several other Mario games. Like, I swear Nintendo just programmed it so that you can get infinite 1-ups in, like, the second level of every game. Oh, a lot of the games, anyway. So, it's right over here. I'm actually just gonna... Okay, there's nothing for doing that, apparently. Is there anything up there? No. It's this Koopa right here. So what you want to do, you want to get on the edge of this block, and when he gets close, drop onto him. And you'll hit him like that. Now, I actually did that a little bit wrong. You want to drop just here. And then Mario's going to continually jump on him. And while he's doing this, as you can see, the 1-ups are going up. You can get up to crown 1-ups this way, which I think equates to 1,110 1-ups. Because you get, like, 999, and then the first 9 turns into a crown, which equates to, like, 1,000. And then you can get another 99, and then the second 9 turns into a crown, which equates to 1,010. And then you... No, 1,100, sorry. And then you can get another 10, which equates to 1,100... Oh, and 10! So I'm gonna go... I'm just gonna get 100 lives. I'm not gonna, like, max them out right now. Between episodes, I might actually get maximum lives, because... I don't know, I just like to have maximum lives in this game. I know it might be considered cheating, but it's just something I kind of want to... I wanted to show that off, at least. And I might as well show off Crown, 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 am I right? Because there's no way that we're actually going to get Crown, Crown, Crown without doing it that way. So I figured I might as well... I might as well show it off. So I guess between episodes, I'll probably go back and get maximum lives there. Take you out, sir. Get that star medal, and I believe there's something back here. I'm going to do that rolling long jump. Yep, third star medal, actually. Yeah, the rolling long jump is really good for, like, speedrunning and stuff. It really speeds you up. And, I don't know, I quite like using it. It's one of my favorite moves to use in this game. Oops. Alright, so I am just gonna use the Tanuki suit here. And we're gonna get up onto this platform right here. That's another thing Mario can do. He can jump off of walls, by just pressing the jump button when you're, like, sliding on a wall like that. It's called a wall kick or a wall jump. But with that, we've completed the second level. Woohoo! Awesome. Not bad. And this is going to open up something a little different. Which, I believe it explains what it is when we go in here. Welcome to the mystery box. Clear the room and get the item before time runs out. You might even find a star medal. The clock is ticking, so basically all you have to do in this one, take out the two fake Goombas, and there's your star medal. That is it. That is all that you have to do from this. Then you just wait for it to run out. Wait for the time to run out. And see what you can get Mario to do in the last frame. Did you get the star medal star medal? Mystery boxes you play will be sent with your Mii to other players from now on if you're using Street Pass. You might also receive new mystery boxes from them through Street Pass. That's it for now, see you in the next mystery box. So, I do have Street Pass enabled, but when the hell do I leave the house? So I'm probably not going to get any Street Pass mystery boxes. But because of that, it is entirely possible to get like 999 star medals. So, that's a little annoying to me, because completionist, and it bugs me. But anyway, let's go on to World 1-3. It bugs me that it's a possibility that you can do that. Alright, oh, this level! I remember this level. So, there's a Toad up here. Let's zoom in on him. And then he's going to throw out a star coin for us, which is going to land all the way down there. So, they do a lot of stuff like this, like hide, I'm going to turn the 3DS down, actually. It's a bit loud in my ears. They hide star coins and other stuff with Toads, essentially, and you've got to find them when you go in the camera like that. I believe this mystery box down here, actually, this is like an in-level mystery box, but it's a tiny bit different. Okay, yeah, this just gives us coins. That's literally all this is, so it just gives it jumping consecutively.
And breaking all of the box.
That didn't make sense. Getting all the coins out of the box. There we go. That's all that's for, but there is a few, I believe, mystery boxes, damn it, later on in the game that actually give you star coins within levels like that, so. I'm gonna use the Tanuki suit right here, and try and jump on the top of these bitty buds right here. I believe they're called bitty bugs. What? Okay, apparently that didn't work. Well, we lost all our power-ups now. Simple moving platform right here. You just stand on the arrow of the direction you want to go. And that's pretty much it. Here we got some regular piranha plants, although they are actually fire-shooting piranha plants, so they look a little different. I guess they're supposed to look different to regular ones? I've never actually noticed that. I guess the regular ones just chomp on you in this game. Okay, you can just ground pound those, and then you don't want to head over there yet, but hello, Fireflower. I'll take you just nicely. You want to head over this way. See, there's a regular piranha plant. Yeah, literally all they do is chomp. So you want to get to this block and ground pound on it. And then you'll head into the sky, into a little secret area. Get this, get the star, and run for it. Now, I believe there's a bunch of enemies here. Yeah, if you hit all the enemies, which I failed to do, wonderful, you will get a 1-up. Because, like, if you get consecutive kills on enemies, you'll get 1-ups. However, I failed it, so just forget I said anything. I'm gonna switch back to the Tanuki right here. And, red coin hoop. You go through this, and only five red coins. I forgot about that. In all other games, it's 8 red coins, but in this game, 5 red coins will appear. You collect them all and get a 1-up. You can sometimes get power-ups and other stuff like that. Now, there is a star medal down here, so I'm just going to go ahead and float down with our Tanuki suit. Hopefully that appears. There we go. And that is all of the star coins for this level. I don't want to lose my Tanuki suit, because golden flagpole. So wait, I've been saying top of the flagpole in when I'm playing through 3D World on stream, but now I've got to say golden flagpole. Alright, so it's literally just a case of long jumping and landing on top of it like that. I wasn't sure if I was going to get that because I couldn't really tell where it was in 3D space. That's why 3D can come in handy, so I may have to turn it on at certain points. And there we go, yet another level complete. And that's going to open up World 1-4, which is... Oh, it actually requires us to unlock this one. Now, I'm not sure if this level is actually required. Let's go ahead and head in here. Yeah, it's not required. So there are some non-required levels. But of course, we are going to do it because we're going for 100%. So we're going to spend 3 star medals to unlock this level. I say spend. You get them straight back. So, oh, this level. Let's do this. This is going to be fun. This is going to be fun level. Let's-a-go. This one's based entirely around these platforms, like the one that... We stood on one of these platforms in the previous level and they decide to throw the next level at us that is just full of the things, so... It's a case of just standing on them. With the Tanuki suit, I'm gonna actually get another one. You can just stand at the front and really spin anything that comes your way. You can also use it to spin into coins and stuff like that to collect them if they go past you or whatever, but preferably I just stand here and I spin around like this. Normally you avoid a bunch of the Goombas. But then you can actually take it over water things like this and get stuff like star medals. And I believe 2, if not 3 of the star medals actually require you to do that, so... And obviously that first one. I know that the last one does. I'm not entirely sure where the middle one is. I don't recall. But yeah, this level, levels like this do get somewhat... Not tedious. Oh my god, I'm still on the fence. But I don't know, they can feel like they get kind of, not boring, but like, you do a lot of standing, so. And actually the other one, the second one is right over here. So I'm just gonna go over here, excuse me, Goomba, get on that, make sure it doesn't ride off the edge. Because that would suck. Here's another coin, there's a fire piranha plant right there. And then I believe we're actually pretty close to the end of the level. Oh yeah, there's a mystery box right here. I remember some things about this game. Another Tanuki suit that we do not need right now, but that is literally everything in this room, so... Hello, Mario. How are you today? Okay. Just coins. I hate it when they give you question mark blocks, and then they've just got coins in them. Anyway, so there is another star medal right here. What you want to do is kind of... There we go. Make sure you're going to the left when you actually get up on this one. And it's going to fall down. Now, this one can be kind of awkward to get on. You've got to get on this second one here. And actually, I think I did it all right. Yeah, okay, I did that fine first try. Usually, it, like, doesn't push me up the right way, or I fall off, or whatever, but... We actually did this level pretty flawlessly for a first attempt. So, not bad if I do say so myself. And let's be pro. Can I land on that top bit? I think if you want to land on the top bit, you've got to go jump from where I did. Yeah, 3 coins, just what I was looking for. The sarcasm is real. Okay, so for this one, if you miss the frigging jump here, you are not getting top of the flagpole. But I didn't miss it, so everything's good. Plus, even if you miss it, you've got to go back through that long frigging level again, so... Yeah, not fun. But we've only got one main level left. I'm gonna show you what this is. This is a toad house, or... Is it called Toad House or Mushroom House in this game? It's called a Toad House. Welcome to the Toad House. There is a present inside here for you. Oh, there is a present here for you. It doesn't even say inside. Yes, it does. I wonder what's inside. Sorry, I've not recorded in a little while. Can you tell? Alright, what do we got, Toad? A fire flower. Why not? I suppose I'll take it. And I like how if you collect power-ups like a fire flower or whatever while using the Tanuki suit, it just kind of looks like Mario's, like, spinning his butt around at the power-up. Alright, World 1 Castle. The final level of World 1. Let's go. Oh yeah. Let's do this. I'm actually going to use the Tanuki suit to start off with. I think we get given... Wow. Never mind. I was going to say I think we get given another Tanuki suit, but I sure hope we do now, because I frigging lost that one. There is a star medal right above here. That would have been made a lot easier with the Tanuki suit, because I could have just floated over it. Yeah, we do get another Tanuki suit. See, that's why I didn't want to use the fire flower, because I knew that if I lost the fire flower, I wouldn't get it back. See? I meant to lose the Tanuki suit there. I completely and utterly meant to lose the Tanuki suit, and I totally meant to do it there as well. I'm bad at this game. I'm sorry, I'm dead. Oh my god, I died! Are you kidding me? And now it was right after the checkpoint though, so that's fine. That was really bad. I'm not gonna deny that. Okay, that's just coins again. You can actually ground pound on these endless coin blocks and sort of continually ground pound. And it gets all the coins out of them, but yeah. There's just a 1-1 up there. Those are actually fake, so I don't know why they do that. Anyway, let's take a look through here. What do we got? I keep pressing the X button. And that takes us out of it. It's Toad! It's Toad! Bowser has kidnapped Toad, and what's betting he's gonna say our princess is in another castle? Or something like that. So, I wonder what is going to happen here. I bet nobody saw that one coming. Although, actually, there is something a little interesting about this- Okay, I'm using my fire flower. Something a little interesting about this Bowser. That you won't probably see straight away. But you guys will probably know this when we get closer to him. Just take a quick look at Bowser right here. You notice anything different about him? Damn it. Anything different? You notice anything different about him? Anything at all? I wonder what it could be. Is it perhaps his tail? Yeah, Bowser actually had a Tanuki tail because it wasn't Bowser at all. It was a Goomba using a Tanuki suit that apparently also made him look like Bowser? I don't quite understand that, but I also don't understand why he leaves a button here for us to hit to kill him. So we save Toad. And oh, now I have to get top of the flagpole without a Tanuki suit. This will be interesting. So I'm going to try doing my rolling long jump. Oh, I don't know if I can do this. I did it. Never mind, I frigging did it. Ignore everything I said. Wahoo! And with that, World 1 is complete. Took us about... Wow, about 25 minutes. It took longer than I was expecting, actually. Maybe I shouldn't make these episodes one world per episode. Whatever, let's go on to World 2 and see what happens. So yeah, we got another postcard from Bowser. And actually, I didn't mention before, because it was just in the middle of the cutscene, the first one at least, you can actually shake the 3DS when those postcards are being viewed, and it moves them. So that's why they've been moving, because I've actually been shaking the 3DS. So I just thought that's a little, an interesting little detail. So, ooh, this looks like a nice little level. You may also have noticed, I'll just go back to World 1. These levels don't have any kind of theme. Like, they're not like a grassland world, it's not like a... anything like that. And World 2 isn't specifically a desert world. It is yellow to make it look kind of like a desert world. But it's not specifically a desert world, because this is not a desert level, is it? Anyway, I think that's actually going to do it for the first episode of this Let's Play, because, you know, we did World 1. And that's all I wanted to do for the first episode. Because I'm not just going to make the first episode into, like, four worlds or whatever. Anyway. Let me know what you guys thought of this first episode. Sorry, I'm, like, hiccuping a lot. And it's bugging me. Let me know what you guys thought of this first episode, because I am very excited to continue doing this Let's Play. And I'm just so glad I can finally do 3DS stuff. It's, like, so appealing to me. And I'm probably going to get a lot of DS and 3DS content out within the coming weeks. So I hope you guys don't mind that. So yeah, leave a like on this video if you did enjoy. It helps me out a ton. And subscribe if you are new. We are getting a decent following now, which is very, very much appreciated. And I love every one of you guys for it. So thank you all once again for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for World 2 of Super Mario 3D Land. I will see you guys then. Oh, and I'm also gonna go get infinite 1-ups, because why not?